we'll start with the next topic, that is umbilical malformation and umbilical hernia. So most of the umbilical disorders, okay, most of the umbilical disorder usually occurs due to failure of embryological or physiological processes. So most of the umbilical disorders usually occurs due to failure of embryological and physiological processes, and it also occurs due to unusual umbilical anatomy, that is single umbilical artery, or abnormal position of the umbilicus, okay, abnormal position of the umbilicus, or it might be associated with congenital abnormalities, okay, it might be associated with congenital abnormalities. So that is usually about this thing. So that is mainly most of the umbilical disorders usually occurs due to failure of normal embryological and physiological processes, and it also occurs due to unusual umbilical anatomy. Okay, it usually occurs due to unusual umbilical anatomy, such as single umbilical artery, or abnormal position of the umbilicus, or abnormal position of the umbilicus, or it might be associated with congenital abnormalities. So to be today's topic, I'll be dealing with it is umbilical malformation, umbilical hernia. So what is this umbilical malformations? It might be occurring due to failure of normal embryological processes or physiological processes, or it can occur due to unusual umbilical anatomy. Okay, it usually occurs due to unusual umbilical anatomy. So that is usually such as it might be due to single umbilical artery, or abnormal position of the umbilicus, okay, abnormal position of the umbilicus, or it might be due to umbilical congenital abnormalities, okay, it can be due to congenital abnormalities. So with this malformations, we'll see the first one, like the disorders that we usually see, it is mainly umbilical hernia, okay, the disorders that we usually see, it is umbilical hernia. So the umbilical cord, so umbilical hernia, so we'll see detailly about this, what is umbilical hernia. So but in this umbilical hernia, before moving on to the umbilical hernia, we'll see what is this umbilical cord. So what is umbilical cord? Umbilical cord, it is nothing but a cord which connects mother to the fetus, okay, it connects the mother to the fetus inside the womb, okay. So that is, it is the cord which usually connects the mother with the fetus inside the womb. So that is usually about this thing. So that is usually, and this usually most of the case, the hole which is there, it usually closes after the birth, okay. So that is the hole which is formed, it usually closes after the birth. So umbilical hernia, okay, so umbilical hernia occurs when the stomach muscle do not join completely, okay. The umbilical hernia occurs when the stomach muscles do not join completely and the intestine protrude through the weak spot around the belly button, okay, and the intestine protrude to the weak spot around the belly button, okay, weak spot around the belly button. So that is umbilical hernia. So umbilical hernia, it is nothing but it occurs when the stomach muscles does not join completely, with stomach muscle does not join completely, and also usually it does not join completely, and it usually the intestine usually protrude into the around the belly button, around the weak spot of the belly button. So what is umbilical hernia? Umbilical hernia, it is nothing but the stomach muscles does not join completely, and due to this the intestine protrude into the weak spot of the belly button, that is umbilicus, okay, belly button, that is umbilicus. So what is umbilical cord? It connects mother with the fetus, and this forms a hole, and this hole usually closes after the birth. And what is umbilical hernia now? So umbilical hernia, it is usually the hernia which occurs when the stomach muscles does not join completely, and due to this the intestine protrude into the weak spot of the belly button, okay, weak spot of the belly button, that is umbilical, that is umbilicus. So that is usually there, and this is one of the common problems of the infants, and seen in one among 8 to 10 infants. Again, 8 to 10 infants, at least one infant will be suffering from this umbilical hernia. So this is the common problems of the infants. This is the common problems of the infants. It is seen that in 8 to 10 infants, at least one infant will be suffering from this umbilical hernia. So next is causes of this umbilical hernia. So what are the causes of this umbilical hernia? This is most seen in this low birth weight babies. Okay, the babies are low birth weight babies, or the baby are suffering from chromosomal abnormalities, that is trisomy 13 to 18, or in case of premature babies, okay, in case of premature baby. So this umbilical hernia usually occurs in the when the baby is low birth weight baby or premature baby, or in case of chromosomal abnormalities, that is trisomy 13 to 18. So that is usually about this causes. It is seen mostly in the low birth weight babies, premature babies, and in case of if there is having chromosomal abnormalities such as trisomy 13 to 18. So that is usually there. So next is symptoms. So what are the symptoms that usually we can see in case of this umbilical hernia? Is that umbilical hernia, it usually seen can usually be seen, okay, umbilical hernia can usually be seen when the baby starts crying, okay, when the baby starts crying, laughing, or when the baby stain or gives a stain or pressure in the bathroom, okay, when the baby gives a pressure in the bathroom. So that time usually we can see this umbilical hernia. So umbilical hernia can be seen when the baby cries, when the baby laughs, or when the baby gives strain in the bathroom. So that time usually we can see this umbilical hernia. So that is how we can see there will be a swelling or bulge like, okay, what we can see, this swelling or bulge like near the navel area, okay, swelling or bulge can be seen near the navel area, and this will be very painful, okay, and this will be very painful. So that is usually symptoms. It is usually seen that the umbilical hernia can be usually seen, okay, the umbilical hernia can be usually seen in the children when the children cry, laugh, or when they put some strain in the bathroom. So that time usually we can see this umbilical hernia, and this usually it looks like it is swelling or bulge, okay, it usually looks like swelling and bulge near the navel area, okay, swelling or bulge near the navel area, and this can be very painful, okay, and this can be very painful. The other symptoms that we can see in case of this umbilical hernia, it is that I've told you first is pain, vomiting, because the child will be having vomiting, and the swollen and the bulge, okay, these are the main symptoms: pain, vomiting, swelling or bulge. See, other symptoms that we can see, it is mainly fever, constipation. So the pain will be very severe, that is severe abdominal pain will be there, and also redness or discoloration, okay, redness and discoloration. So that is, these are the symptoms that is usually seen in case of umbilical hernia. So what are the symptoms that we should see? So normally like umbilical hernia can be seen in the children when the children laughs, cries, or put pressure in the bathroom. So that time you can feel this umbilical hernia. So this can be felt as though there is swelling or bulge near the navel area, and this usually the symptoms, it is mainly we see pain, swelling or bulge, and also they'll be having vomiting. Other than that, the other symptoms that can be felt, it is mainly fever, constipation, severe abdominal pain, or also redness or discoloration, okay, redness or discoloration. So this is about the symptoms that usually we can see. So next is diagnostic evaluation. So what are the diagnostic evaluation that we go? So mainly we have to go with physical examination to check for the swelling or bulge near the navel area, and next we go with x-ray and ultrasound. So physical examination that we go, diagnostic evaluation that we usually do, it is mainly physical examination and x-ray and ultrasound. Physical examination is mainly done to see, feel the bulge or swelling near the navel area. So that is usually done. So management. So what is the management that we usually go in this? Management, it is usually seen that this closes automatically by 3 to 5 years. Okay, this usually closes when the child reaches 3 to 5 years of age. If at all after this also, after 3 to 5 years also, if it is not closing, okay, if it is not corrected by itself, then we have to go with surgical correction. Okay, then we have to go with surgical correction. So surgery is required. Before 5 years also the surgery can be done. If the surgery is required when the hernia becomes very painful, and it is usually 1.5, size has increased about 1.5 inch in diameter, so that time surgery has to be done. So the following reasons have to be kept in mind if surgery has to be done before 5 years of age. Normally after 5 years age it closes automatically, but before that if this features develop or if the symptoms develop, then we have to go with surgery. So that is, if pain is very severe and the size is increased, like 1.5 inch in diameter it has been increased, and also it is usually does not shrink, okay, it is not shrinking after 1 year, okay, if it is not shrinking after 1 year, then it does not go, or like after 3 to 5 years also if it is not going, so that time also we have to go with surgery. And it usually blocks the intestine, okay, if it blocks the intestine, then we have to go for surgery, okay, then we have to go with surgical correction. So management, normally it usually spontaneously it closes, like this umbilical hernia usually closes by 3 to 5 years, and if at all if it is not closing, then we have to go with surgical correction. And before that also, that is before the closure, like before 5 years of age also, if such features develop, then we have to go with surgical correction. So that is mainly if it becomes very painful, then if it is 1.5 inch in bigger, it has increased in diameter, so that time we have to do. And then if it blocks the intestine, that we have to do. And then it does not shrink, okay, it is not shrinking, okay, if it is not shrinking, then we have to go with surgical correction, okay. Surgical correction is very much required after this symptoms when it is developed. So what are the surgical correction that we go? So normally we go with suture repair, okay, normally we go with suture repair. Now what is a suture repair? Suture repair, it is nothing but in which it is a primary type of umbilical hernia repair, okay, it is a primary type of umbilical hernia repair where the surgeon makes an incision near the hernia site, okay, it makes an incision near the hernia site, and the bulging tissue is gently pushed back, okay, the bulging tissue is gently pushed back into the abdomen, okay, the bulging tissue is gently pushed back into the abdomen, okay, it is pushed back into the abdomen. So sutures are used mainly to repair the muscles, okay, sutures are used to mainly repair the muscles. So this is the surgical correction that we have to do in case of umbilical hernia. So what is done? So we go with mainly suture repair, and the suture repair, it is mainly done in infants and children. This is a primary type of umbilical hernia repair. Here the surgeon, they will just make an incision near the hernia site, and the bulging tissues will be pushed back into the abdomen, and then it will be sutured, the muscles will be sutured. So that is usually about this suture repair. Then we have to educate them, we have to educate the mothers regarding, of parents regarding the complications that develop after this, and they should immediately inform it to the doctor. So what are the things? If infection develops at the site, okay, if the infection develops at the site, then if hernia reoccurred, okay, after the surgical correction also, if hernia reoccurred, then they should immediately inform it to the doctors. Then numbness in the legs, okay, if the child is having numbness in the leg, that also should be informed. Nausea, continuous nausea, vomiting is there, then it should be informed. And also if headache is there continuously, then also it should. So all the symptoms should be informed about these complications. It should be educated to the parents so that immediately they, for the case, like they consult with the doctor. So what are the complications that develop? Mainly infection can develop, and then hernia can reoccur, nausea, numbness in the legs, and headache. So if these complications are seen, okay, if these symptoms are seen, okay, if these symptoms are seen, then they have to immediately refer the case. Then they have to immediately consult with the doctor. So this is about this umbilical management of this umbilicus hernia. So what is that? Mainly it closes normally by 3 to 5 years. If it is not closing, then surgical recorrection should be done. Before that also, if it is not showing any symptoms of closing, then we have to check, then we have to go for surgical recorrection. Then the surgical recorrection before this 5 years or before the closure, what are the things that we have to do? Surgical correction, why we have to do, in the sense, it might be including such as if pain is severe, size has increased, blocks the intestine, so all such time, then we have to go with surgical correction. Surgical correction, what we do, we go with suture repair. So in this, mainly a surgeon makes an incision near the navel area, the bulging tissue will push back into the abdomen, and then suture, then they will be suturing the muscles. And then the parents should be educated regarding the signs and symptoms that develop after the surgery, and that has to be informed to the doctor so that immediate treatment can be done. So this is about the management of this umbilical hernia. So in this video, we have studied about this umbilical malformation and umbilical hernia. Umbilical malformation occurs when there is it usually occurs if there is failure of embryological or physiological processes, or if there is unusual umbilical anatomy, like single artery, umbilical artery, or wrong position of the umbilicus, or in case of congenital anomalies. So in that, we have seen about the umbilical hernia. Umbilical hernia, it is nothing but where stomach muscles does not join completely, and the intestine protrude into the umbilicus. Okay, the intestine protrude into the weak portion of the umbilicus. So this is about this umbilical hernia.